everyone. Welcome back to my channel. This is Olivia. How are you all? I'm very sorry for taking a very long break on YouTube, but I thought for Christmas this year, I'm going to do like a few tutorials and color along just so we can celebrate Christmas together. And for the first tutorial, I want to do like a series of Christmassy background or holiday background. This background, of course, you don't have to just use for Christmas coloring, but you can also apply it for other illustration when you color in your books as well. So just basically, I would like to show you the technique I like to use for them. So for the first one in the series, I know this one a lot of you have asked for, which is a simple bokeh. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you three ways of how to color them, how to create them, and if you don't know what they look like, when it incorporates into your coloring pages, it gives like a more of the magical feelings, really enchanting. And those are on the paper that you bring out. This is from John Hannah Bassford. Some things look like this, quite fancy. Or you can do a little bit more simple. Let me see. Or like this. So I will show you that today. We're gonna use a lot of soft pastel and also pencil as well, just so you have like different options so you can use. Without further ado, let's get started. So let's start with the first style that I'm going to do. Now this is the one that I use the most lately, and I'm using this brand Pan Pastel. Now this one is the artist quality, so it is a little bit on the pricey side. However, with the quality of the pigment and how much you get in the set, I think it is quite worthwhile. Make sure you keep an eye out for like sales or the end of the holiday or like the summer holiday. Usually they're on sales a lot. Now this one I got is from the set of Eco Pure Colors. They include a lot of colors that I found that is really easy to use. This is a set I recommend for like beginner and for specifically coloring artists, because you get X amounts of colors in the set and you can use for so many things, not just like this background. I like using this, but I will show you another one when I use a normal pastel, like the chalk pastel one. But let's get started. And I'm going to first one, because it's Christmas or something festive, I kind of am thinking about like a red. They come with a tons of applicator, and what you can do with this one is it's usually reusable, so if it's dirty you can wash it, let it dry and reuse again until they kind of tear. But they're pretty durable. For this one, you don't really need to use a lot of pressure to apply that, because they're quite pigmented. They're very pigmented actually, and you see like they're thin, like each pen is doesn't look like much, but because you only use a tiny bit of amount. I've been using this for a while. I don't think it even go down at all. So what I like is I'm going to, usually with the background, you can just apply it down. If you notice earlier when I show you a page in John Hannah Christmas, I use exactly the same technique. Well, very similar. I think it's there's a few different colors in there, but basically I'll use a red. Also in the Christmas page that I show you with the background, it is the same types of color combination. I'm gonna show you a few color combination just so you have some different choices when it comes to these kind of background. Now if you think about Christmas, there's red or green or yellow, things like that. Now for this one, I want it to be quite simple so everyone can do it. This one is a type of beginner level. So even if you just start out, it is not difficult at all. Now they do come with a rail applicator that is a little bit easier to use, but I'm running out of the sponge, like the top bit, and they're not very clean right now, so I'm just using this one. You see, is you just try to have a nice flat layer to it. Now with this one, you have to use this kind of pastel to achieve. I'm gonna show you one example when you use pencil. Of course you can use pencil to create bokeh. However, in a small background it is good. But if you try to create like a big background, it still work, but it's gonna take a lot of time to do. And I know that a lot of people have chronic pain in their hands and their wrists, so I found this method doesn't take much time, really enjoyable process, and you get just as good effect. Alright, so that is the colors you want it to be. It's nice and vibrant. Once you got that done, the next thing you want to do, now you're gonna need one of these electric eraser. You don't have to get this brand. Now I have this brand for a long time, this one, the Derwent brand, but there is a lot of other brands out there that you can buy for a lot cheaper. This one is only 10 bucks, so it's not that expensive, and you can buy the refillable for the eraser. Now what I like about this is it's quite strong, and it's like a pencil, like the way you hold it like a pencil, so it's so easy to control. And what you want to use this for is you're gonna create the shape for the circle, the light that appear at the background. Now of course you can use a normal eraser as well, but I find that it's not strong enough to erase it cleanly. If you're not good at drawings, at doing circle, you can use one of these, kind of draw out shape on the ruler, and then you can just sketch out and then use a eraser to follow. Now what I'll do is I'm gonna erase out a lot of circles, a different size recommend. So I'm gonna just do some circle, quite simple. So once you're done, now don't use your hand to swipe it, because all of these pigment on here will just kind of ruin everything on your page. So what I like to do, get a brush. Now this is a makeup brush, and you can just gently flick it off. The next color I'm going to use is yellow. A nice vibrant yellow will do. You don't have to use exactly the same yellow, but I found this is the only bright yellows in this set, I think. So I'm gonna use this one, and for this one they do come with these little look like eyes makeup applicator, the eyeshadow applicator, but actually I'm not sure if they're the same material. I may try that out. What I like to do is I will pick up the yellow from the pan, and you can go in and just smudging it around to create create some yellow highlight. Of course, you can just do white for this one, but I found that when it have a few other color, especially yellow, when you do these kind of bokeh, I would always highly recommend yellow and white for a Christmassy feel. You know, of course, you don't have to use this. You can use a ton of different colors, but these are like the two colors that I found it would go well with almost any other base color. So if you have green, the yellow and the white go well with the green too. You have blue, it go pretty well too. So that's a little trick for you if you don't know, because it can be confusing when you color with the pencil and with a more advanced types of bokeh background. You use a lot of other colors for the lights, because eventually this light circle, it just kind of reflect the blurs of the object behind in the background. So of course this will contain a lot of other colors, but these are just like a simple way to do, and it always guarantee that you can get a really nice result. You can overlap some of them. You can see this one, I kind of overlap a little bit. Maybe we can apply for that one too. Yeah, that's look good. Okay, and the next one, which is the final colors, is white. And it's a little bit dirty because I pick up dust from other colors on here, which I should have cleaned my applicator, and you put it on. Now I highly recommend you put the white on top, and you're wondering, oh, you already like erase it, why would I put it on top of the white for? Because you can see, compared to this one, is it pick up, this eraser will pick up a lot of the pigment, so the next color you apply, it will show a lot better. And I like the perfect circle, so when you're applying in the white, it blur the edges as well, and it just make it more complete. Another thing you can do is you can use the kneaded eraser. And now if you don't have the kneaded eraser, you can use a normal eraser, but you know, the square eraser, you can just cut the snip at the edge of the eraser to create like the pointy tip. It's just easier for you to control. And then I dab off some of these circle. I like to pick up the red from the other applicator, because now you can apply like just a little bit of like a pinkish, like a very light red. Now you can do this with other background you do. This is to create like a soft look. Now that's a little bit too dark. Once it, when it's too dark like that, you can just get a piece of tissue and just kind of wipe it off, dab it up, the colors off, to make sure it's not too dark, because when it's too dark, you just kind of cover it up again with in the background. So I like to be a little bit more on the light side, and it just give a little bit more of the blurry look. Okay, once you are done and you are happy with the whited look, you can go in with a white gel pen. Now this is look completely fine, and I completely happy with it, but when you go in with the gel pens, just add some more dot. Just a gel pen is really nice and bright, will help to add the extra magical touch to it. There you go. And if you want to, you can add like a little star. Maybe you can add one. Yeah. So that is our first style of mocha that you can do. Now, moving on to the second. I'm going to use this normal brand pastel. So this one is a student brand, just a student quality, and they are still great. So I want to show you, even with a more cheaper supply, you can still use it. Now for the second one, I might do, let's do a green one. So with this one, because it's not very strong pigment, I like to scratch it up, and I don't usually use it to actually apply straight on the paper, only because sometimes they don't blend, they don't have enough binder in them to help blending nicely. So what I do, I use an exacto knife, like just a crafting knife, and I scratch off the pigment on here. So for this one, my favorite applicator for them is the makeup pad. Really cheap, you can find it anywhere in the drugstore. And I just fold it up and I just wrap it in. You can see the colors still look really nice. It is a little bit washed out. You can always go back. I'm gonna go back. To be quite dark on one side. You can see it build up. Usually in coloring book, I found that it can build up to 2 or 3 layer if you use a normal pastel. You can see that's done. I'm gonna go with the yellow, the orangey yellow. Let's add just a little bit on one edges. I use the same one. Once again, I'm going to use the eraser to create the polka. And the fun bit in this one is we can create with different shape of polka. So this one you see here, which is a circle, the most common shape one, you can create heart, you can create diamond shape, which is really nice too. I like to use a white pencil to do so, because usually for soft pastel I like to do a dark layer. Of course, if you have like a lighter base color, just use something more on the lighter side, like a light pink or like a light green or light yellow. So for this one, maybe I'll do like a diamond shape. Add that in. Again, the same principle, you do several different smalls and big size. Once you have the shape now, I'm going to use my eraser to erase the shape of it. Just swipe it off once again. Now, once you got it done, you're just going to use the yellow again, like I said, yellow colors, and I just use the applicator to pick it up. Now if you do this and you don't have this applicator, use eyeshadow. I did try to use eyeshadow before, the eyeshadow applicator before, with these kind of pastel on the chalk like this, and they work great. But I don't have them at the moment, so I'm just gonna use this one. I just pick up straight from the piece because you're gonna go in detail and it's kind of hard to scratch it off and blend. So just do that and apply some colors in. Now it is a little bit light at the moment, but I'm gonna show you how to make them brighter. Now you just kind of pick. I just want to have the base color down first. I'm just going to use the same green that we use for the base, and I'll just pick it up a little bit. But it's not too dark. For this white, you just go in with the white, and the same thing, you can pick it up. You can use any pencil that you have. I'm going to use the Prismacolor, and I'm just gonna go in with the yellow, and now I can shape it. Now because we have the base color, the yellow base color from the soft pastel already, the color will come out more vibrant. Okay, I'm just adding in some. Just refine the edges of this one, and you do the same with the white too. And I use a very light green for this one. I'll include the color that I used down below if you're interested in using them. Once you're done with that green, try to go back in with a little bit of white on top to make that green nice and light. There you go. So once you have that done, that pretty much the whole background you want to do. Now you can replace the shape, like I said, of the bokeh with just the circle. It's a lot easier to do, but I just kind of want to show you a different way to do it. And now you can go in with your trusty white gel pen. What I like to do is I also add in some small diamond shape with this one, because it pop a lot more again the background. And I like to create like the little dot like this. Okay, and once you're done, I'm just gonna add in some circles, some more dot. There you go. So that's one is done. You can see it still look really nice and cool. Now for our last one, I'm going to use a polychromite pencil. Of course you can use any pencil that you own, but you guys seem to like it when I use Polychromo for tutorials, so I'm going to use them today. And all you really need to do, now again, if you're not really good with circle, I like for the pencil, I have to sketch out the circle first. So what I like to do is, now for this background in particular, I'm going to do a combination of blue and pink. So for the background, for the bokeh, like I said earlier, try to use something really light in colors. So I'm gonna use, this one is a sky blue. In first the middle teal blue, and for this kind of background, the bokeh with the pencil, you need to build up layers by layers, so that's why it takes a little bit longer time to do this kind of background. So I'm gonna go in lightly. I usually kind of blend where the color gonna go in my head, so I think it's around here that we need to stop. Pretty much for this kind of background, you can just go randomly. The rest of the space for the pink. Now next, I'm going to add in just a tad of the light ultramarine. Blend that in. Move around the circle. Now with this method, it's a little bit more tricky because you need to know what color it will create when you blend certain color, only because with this pencil, they're very easy to create a brown colors, and of course you don't really want a brown background when you're not intended to, because it's not a nice brown. It is going to be like a more muddy types of brown, so I would just be careful when you're doing this. Research your color first, test it out on a piece of paper to see if they fit well, they blend well, what sort of color they're gonna create if you're layering them, and go from there. So because these types of background, if you do with pencil, it takes a lot of time, so you don't want to accidentally ruin your pages making a muddy colors. Okay, I'm happy with that. Now I'm gonna go in with the sky blue. Don't be feel beat up when you do this, because it will look ugly for a long time until it's starting to look good. So just be patient. Okay, so that's done. I'm going to add in the brush and blue now for some of the shadows. I want some really nice dark color so the bokeh can pop up against the background. And you pretty much just have to go back and forth with this blue until you cover all the tooth of the paper, so no white left, no white of the paper show through, and it blend nicely, and then we can start adding in the pink. So I'm just going back and forth with this one. I'm going back in with the middle petal blue, tail blue, and blend in some more. Ultramarine, light ultramarine, just go back in. We almost there. There's no really rules or anything when it comes to these types of background, the way you apply the colors. I just go a lot with like small circle motion. And you can see a lot of people ask me, how do I create like a nice blending colors. It's just a lot of layers, you guys. A lot of patience, especially when you like to use polychromo create a lot of light layer to slowly build up the opacity. And for this certain background, certain color combinations, make sure you always end up at the edge of where you begin to adding in the pink with the sky blue, because it will create the best color combo there. Will give you the nice blend. So just keep that in mind. Okay. See, I'm just going back and forth with this. There is no rules. I just do it until I feel happy with the colors that I laid down. I'm gonna show you one way to blend this quickly, and this is usually what I do when I color by myself, because I want to show, when I do tutorial, I want to show you that you can still create a nice layer without using all this extra medium. But I'll show you, this is a good one for, I think a lot of people already know about them, but if you haven't, I will show them in a minute once we got all the color laid out. So this is the sky blue there. I'm gonna add in right here. Now, I'm gonna add in the light magenta. And just slightly blend it in. So once you are happy with the light out, you can start adding in the blending. Now, I like to use, there's a various way to blend this, especially if you do with a large background. This is probably the better way to do. Derwent blender, so a blender pencil. I have here the Derwent brand. And they're also the one from Prismacolor is called Colorless. And for this one, you really just need to apply a layer on top. I'm just gonna clean up the tip. So for this, you can see once you start apply the pressure there, it will even it out. And I like to blend around these edges of the circle. Just so later on when we're applying in the pencil for those circles, it will look a bit softer. You can see it does help a lot. The only thing with this pencil is you have to have a certain amount of pigment underneath just so it can pick up the color and blend. If you do scratchy, like if you see there's too much white on it, it probably won't work. So make sure you apply a fair bit of layer on before you go in with this. And I'm just adding in for the pink. Adding in the ivory now, and I'm just gonna do that for a few of these simple. Let's just kind of go in. There's no rule for this. So you can see this, the ivory is sort of like a yellowy light, yellow color too. It's not completely white. That's why the same, the yellow work really well for the blue as well. But I just kind of tone down the shades a little bit, so not bright yellow but a little bit more on the lighter side. So I'm gonna go in with the light magenta I try to pick the area that it stay on the blue, so it stand out a little bit more. And I'm gonna add in the sky blue. I'll try to So the final colors you're gonna add in is a white. Now I don't really like the polychromo white, although I like the polychromo pencil, but I don't like it white. It's just too scratchy for me, but I like the white from the Prismacolors a lot more, so I'm gonna use the white from the Prismacolor. So you're gonna go over this bokeh and you're gonna go around and around like this, smudge the edge like this. You see how it blend in? You wanted to create that kind of blurry effect. Be careful when you do this, it's not so you not pick up the base color around onto the bokeh. And then I'll just do for these as well, the rest of this circle. And that is pretty much it. Once you're done, you can start applying in the gel pens. I like to this one. Add a little bit of this small dot just along the line like this to create this magic square. Done with this background, just keep in mind that you need to use a fixative setting to keep them in place, because they are pastel and they're dusty, so they will rub off on the next page if you don't settle them. So I use these ones, the fixative spray. Now a lot of brand will work, doesn't really matter what brand you use, but make sure it safe here, right here, safe for pastel or chalk or charcoal. And really important, it had to be colorless matte finish, because you don't want a glossy finish. Sometimes when you use a glossy finish and you want to apply, let's say, the white gel pen after that, you want to apply some more pencil on after, it won't go on top because it will slide around, so the paper won't pick up the colors anymore. So that's a really important thing when you buy the fixative spray. Now this one is from post office in Australia, so I'm not really sure if you can get it anywhere else. I think this might be like just a home brand, but I'm sure if you look on at your local art shop or on Amazon, there will be a lot of options for you. And when you spray them, please use a well ventilated room, spray them, let them settle for a while, because the smell is horrible, so you don't want to spray that in. It's the end of the our first color along or tutorial for the Christmas, and I hope you enjoyed this one. I'll show you on the area that is not too shiny. You can see the pink a little bit more because it's quite bright over there. There you go, it look a little bit better here. So I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you learned something new. In the meantime, take care, happy coloring, and happy Christmas. Bye. And as always, I would like to say thank you to all my lovely members on my Patreon who supported my work and to make this video available on YouTube for you guys. So if you like any of the pages that I show in this video and you would like to color more with me and learn more technique in real time with voice guidance, please check out the link in the description below and become my member, and I will see you in the next one.